Alrighty guys, and welcome back. Today we're going to be looking at an informative Freddy build that I highly recommend in the red ranks. Now you guys will know I'm currently doing a Freddy streak. It's only at 11 games, but we're going to see how many games we can 4K in a row with Frederick or Freddy, depending on how you want to call it, with no addons, no ruin in the red and the purple ranks. 4K meaning I get every kill and no one escapes via hatch, no one escapes via the exit gate. So let's have a look at a little bit further in depth in the build that I choose to run. Right, I recommend Corrupt Intervention on Freddy. This perk is subject to change based on a couple of things. Now, the reason I recommend Corrupt is I'm going to be looking at stalling out three generators while I build up my power. But before we get into that, guys, make sure you like and subscribe to the video to make sure you have to see any more educational informative content by me, and you can pop into the live streams where I stream DBD 5 days a week. But let's jump straight back into it. Now, before we talk about Corrupt, my four perks: one gen protection, one situational awareness, one stall, and one utility perk, right? One gen protection, Corrupt Intervention. Those three gens are sealed far away while I'm channeling and building up my ability. Now, it does take a little bit of time to get Freddy's ability to work up. He has two abilities. That's how strong he is, all right? Freddy is all about keeping survivors asleep. Now, basically, all survivors fall asleep every 60 seconds. There will be these random clocks around the board, only one clock per player at a time, and each clock a player can walk up to, talk to, or put their hands on, it'll wake them up, and they'll be awake for 90 seconds. Taking any form of damage from Freddy, therefore an M1, an attack with his claw, will force you to fall asleep. While you are asleep, you are not in Freddy's heartbeat. I will repeat, while you're asleep, you are still beside Freddy, but you're not in the heartbeat. Therefore, if you try to do a borrowed time save on somebody, he will not receive the effect of borrowed time, as the person who is doing the save has to be within the killer's heartbeat, and the heartbeat hits zero for Freddy. That is very important to remember, and very strong for the low ranks, when you're going to be versing really good survivors that try and utilize borrowed time. That being said, what is Freddy's other ability? He can put a blood pool on the ground. A blood pool takes about 2 seconds to activate. It takes him about 1 second, 0.5 second to place on the ground. If a survivor is asleep, they will be able to see the blood pools. If they're awake, they're invisible. While you're asleep and you step in a blood pool, you will scream. It'll hinder your movement speed by 15% for 2 seconds or 3 seconds after you leave the blood pool. It is very strong, and it allows him to counter every loop. Every loop's a bit of a stretch. A lot of the jungle gyms. And the thing about Freddy is the faster you play him, the better off you're going to be. When you watch my videos of Freddy, you'll notice I put one blood pool to one loop, and I always hide my light and moonwalk and make those fast plays. When you hesitate, that's when a survivor can outplay you in those current situations. You'll note that at double L walls, I will be able to place one blood pool on either play, depending on which side the killer or the survivor is on, much like when I do it with the clown, to guarantee that hit. Very important to keep in mind, especially if you play a lot of these kind of killers. The same hinder penalty is received from both the clown and Freddy, but the clown penalty after you leave the smoke is 2 seconds rather than the 3 seconds that Freddy has. However, however long you're in the clown bottle, we're not here to talk about the clown, but however long you're in the clown bottle smoke, you will suffer the penalty. And when the bottle expires or the smoke expires, you will then have the 2 second penalty. However, Freddy, once the blood pool is activated, will disappear after a couple of seconds. It'll disappear about 4 seconds after it's been triggered. Freddy can put 10 blood pools on the ground at a given time. Now, the other part of Freddy's ability is he can teleport to a generator of his choice, regardless of where it is on the map, providing the generator is not complete or not sealed. A sealed generator being a Corrupt Intervention generator or a Thrilling Tremor generator. Therefore, if you see a generator people are working on, you can press the control key. After 5 seconds of channeling the ability, during this entire time, blood will pour out of the generator and an illusion of blood will come out of the ground with Freddy Krueger in the blood. You do not have to take the teleport. You can bait it by letting go of the button while you're coming in to distract the survivors while they're looking at the generator, or you could take the teleport. If you bait it, the cooldown is dramatically reduced. If you take the teleport, you reset your ability. You can still use the dream snares. Now, Freddy does have an add-on that allows him to have dream pallets, which replaces the dream snares, and therefore survivors that have destroyed pallets, or you can place fake pallets around the board to confuse survivors. They will see fake pallets only when they're asleep. If they pull down a fake pallet, it'll explode with blood. It doesn't hinder the movement speed, but they're obviously locked in animation while they're pulling down the pallet. It is phenomenally weak. I do not recommend it as opposed to Blood Pool Freddy. Now, the build. Corrupted Dimension will seal the three furthest away generators. Keeping this in mind, that when they're sealed, this is giving me time to build up my ability naturally. My ability being my ability to teleport around the board. Therefore, it's pretty crucial at the start of the trial. I could replace Corrupt with Horned Ground or a form of Snowball. Even save the best for last. Sloppy Butcher for consistency. Devour Hope. Make your choice if I wanted to rotate. A lot of ways. That's a free perk, if I'm going to be honest. But I do find the most success through Corrupt Intervention. The next perk is Thrilling Tremor. Now, here's the thing with Thrilling Tremor. This seals generators for 16 seconds. A survivor is not on. So if a survivor is working on the generator and I just picked up Jeff, the generator will not glow white. If a survivor is not on a generator and I just picked up Jeff, the entity's hand will cover the generator and it will glow white. So I know nobody is working on that and no one can work on that for 16 seconds. Nothing trumps it. Now let's skip this perk and go to the next one. Discordance. If more than one survivor is working on a generator, it will pulsate, it'll glow a yellowy-green color, and it will constantly give me a sound notification that there are two or more people on that generator. So here's what you do. You just down Jeff. You see a generator glowing and pulsating. You then teleport over there, but you don't really teleport. It takes 5 seconds of holding control. So at 4.9 seconds, you let go of control, because by then, an illusion of Freddy has came out of the ground, and it looks like he's ready to attack. But then you pick Jeff up from the ground. Those two people will most likely let go of the generator. You've then sealed that generator for 16 seconds. You then get to hook Jeff, and now you have a stack of Pop Goes the Weasel. If you see any other generator glowing, not glowing white and being red, you know there's one player there, there's two players there, and the other player's on the hook. You know where every single person is on the map. Some survivors will greed for the gen when they understand your playstyle, but that is why Discordance and Thrilling are S tier plus perks on Freddy if you know how to use this combo. Pop Goes the Weasel will allow me to decide what needs to happen. If the generator to my left is being worked on, I can then teleport to the jetty to the left, use Pop, and walk across the board. If the generator is nowhere near done and I've walked over there, I'll then teleport back to the jetty that I thought people were nearly done and completed on. It gives so much information and situational awareness, keeping in mind that this build works hand in hand. You could get rid of Pop for Surge, but I find good regression out of Pop, allowing me to know where multiple targets are through Discordance, where I'm going to get the most bang for my buck as well. This is my personal opinion, the best Freddy build. There is nothing better. Now, you could tailor builds based on the map you're going to, like Nurses Calling to the game, for example, but based on no add-ons, no map offering, and RNG, this build has worked for me on every map. Now, I do still lose games, don't get me wrong. I'm not saying I lose every game. I haven't lost the last 10 in a row as Freddy, but still, what I'm saying is the build will fail at times. The way you beat Freddy is like an endurance test. You out-endure him. You wake up, you apply pressure to a gen, you wake up again, you know, you keep your teammates awake, you split pressure. That's how you beat him, right? The way he wins is he keeps as many people asleep and he goes for snowballs. That's Freddy's win condition. If he has an indoor map and you're all asleep, you'll hear the lullaby, much like the Huntress, but you won't be able to hear the heartbeat. So you don't know how close he is when that comes. So keeping that in mind, the lullaby isn't pinpoint directionable. So that's a good understanding of Freddy. You could run Barbecue rather than Thrill, but you can see why I recommend Thrill, Discordance, and Pop with your special ability. I can understand running Barbecue, running Sloppy Butcher, or Save the Best for Last, and Surge if you wanted to do that for the blood points and replace and Corrupt with Horned for the Snowball opportunity, or even Ruin, Surveillance. It depends on what you want to run. Some people go Thanatophobia with add-ons to reduce how long or increase how long it'll take to complete a generator. But like I said before, honestly think this is the best build you can run. I can see running other things, but with a lot of practices playing Freddy, I did put a lot of games into him when I was doing my plague games or my plague streak, but I didn't do them. I only like to do one killer streak at a time because I like to give the hatch and have a little bit of a giggle with the survivors at times. But while we're on the Freddy streak, like I said, guys, this build has performed really well, regardless of the map we've had. So try it out for yourself and let me know in the comments down below. What do you guys think about the build? What do you run on Freddy Krueger? Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, guys, for the YouTube algorithm. And you can pop into the live streams where I stream DBD 5 days a week and you can learn some educational, informative survivor content. It'll be great to teach you a bit about the game, or you can help me teach people that are new to the game and trying to learn. Anyways, guys, stay safe, stay awesome, and I will see you in the next video. Take care, guys.